Hello, beautiful people. My name is Ferdy, and in this video, I will show you how you can create a WordPress website with a booking system. So people can book an appointment at your website. They can choose a service. They can choose a person that offers that service. They can pick a date and they can pick a time. Let me show you what we will cover in this tutorial. This is the website we will create, but it can be about any subject, about any service you offer on your website. Here I click on book an appointment. It's a barbershop website and I can get a mustache trim. Well, I don't need that, or beard trim. But if I would select shaving, for instance, I can select someone who will do that for me, Edward or Thomas or Roy. But if I go back and I go for a mustache trim, there are only two people that can do that. So based on the service you offer, you can assign people that can do that. So I go for the haircut and it will be done by Roy. And then I can select the date. Well, how about Thursday? Okay, well, 9 a.m. Why not? And when I do this and when I book this, 9 a.m. will disappear out of these slots. So we can get your agenda fully booked when you have an appointment system all automatically. I click on next. I can leave my name, Ferdy, my username or my email address. I mean, ferdycorp@gmail.com. My phone number, so they can call me like, hey, where are you? Come on. And I can leave a comment like, I want to have the haircut of Justin Bieber when he was 12. Okay, total amount of $35. If I want to, I can link this to WooCommerce and to Stripe so people can pay up front. So if you have a website with a big bachelor party, like you have a cowboy terrain with horses and people can ride on the horses, do laser gaming or shooting with something, and then at the end they have a beautiful dinner and you say this whole arrangement costs $500 for a group of five people, then you can let them pay up front. So that can be done, but right now I don't do that. I click on book, then I go to a page that says thank you. Okay, but what happens now? I get an email. The website owner gets an email like there's a new booking. So over here it says, hey Ferdy, there's a new booking from Ferdy, that's me, for when? January 28th. This time by who? Roy will be the cutter, the hair cutter, the barber. And which service? A normal haircut, no shaving. This my phone number and the comment, I want to have the haircut of Justin Bieber when he was 12. The total amount will be $35. So now I know, okay, that's okay. I can reply now, say, hey, Ferdy, awesome, looking forward to see you. But Ferdy also, the booker also gets an email. So I go to my Gmail account and there it says your booking is confirmed. Hey Ferdy, we just want to confirm that we received your booking. We are looking forward to see you soon. When this date, you will be served by Roy. Your treatment is a haircut. Your comments, I want to have the haircut of Justin Bieber. The total amount that can be paid at the store is $35. See you soon, Ferdy. Cheers from the other Ferdy. Such a coincidence. This person also is named Ferdy. Okay, so that's what we're going to create. But how are we going to create this? Well, we're going to use a premium tool to create this. It will cost $85 per year, or you get the lifetime access package. I will show you how it all will look. But let me tell you that if you would make a website like this for a client, you can charge $1,500 for it easily. So paying $85 per year, charge $1,500 for it. I think it's a really good deal. I will talk more about it, but let me show you how we are going to create this website. So I log in. So when we have our website up and running, we will create two extra custom post types. What are those? Well, this is a post type, posts. This is a post type called pages, and we will create two extra, in this case called services and barbers. Over here at services, I will add four services I offer for my barbershop, but it can be anything. If I add a new one, I can say ride a pony, scroll down, give the price $199, publish it. I go to the appointments, I have a new service. The same thing goes for barbers. I can add a new barber called Winston and I can add an image of him, this guy. And then over here, I can select a service. He's good in haircutting and helping people to ride the pony. So if I click on publish and I go to the appointment form, ride a pony, and I can select Winston. So we connect the service with the person. Then we will create a booking form. So I go to Jet Engine Forms. And here we have our form. By default, a form is already created, but we're going to improve it, make it look better, And when we do that, we can go to Elementor. Then we can search for a form element. I drag it over here. We can select our form. So here it is. And it can be displayed. By default, it will be displayed like this. But then we're going to make it look better. Right now you see one option, and then you can go to the next page that has everything to do with the page breaks over here. That's what we're going to do. So we're going to style it so it looks better, but then we're going to work with listings. What do I mean by that? If I go to Jet Engine listings, I have two listings. The first one is for the service, the second one for the barbers. If I open this with Elementor, it is actually a template to display this option. I think this looks better than this. So this over here is a listing. So over here, I see the check mark, the title, and the price. So if I would bring this to the right and make the color different, so let's say make it green, it looks like this. And if I want to, I can also add an image over here that is linked to the service dynamic image. I bring it to the center, and if I click on update and I refresh the page, it grabs the thumbnail over here. I know it looks messy, but in this tutorial, I will show you how I can configure it in a way it looks beautiful. So that's what you do with listings. And of course, when people have booked their appointment, I will make sure I get an email as the barber owner. The customer gets a confirmation email, and the customer will be redirected to a thank you page. So how does it look? I scroll down and add forms. I go to our form, and then I scroll down, and over here it says post submit action. So what should happen? Over here, I get a message that there's a new appointment. The barber owner gets an email, the new customer gets an email, and the new customer will be redirected to a certain page. And if I click over here, you see you can automate everything. So the customer gets this email. Hey, Ferdy, we want to confirm that we have a booking for you. When? On the date. They will see all that information. They can reply, and that's the way the cookie crumbles. And if you don't like the colors, I will show you how you can change all the colors over here in a really easy, short time. So I change the color to blue. Look at this. Now everything else is blue. So that's how easy it is to change things in the website. So that is what we're going to create, and that is how we are going to create it. So by now you should know if this is the right fit for your website. Maybe you're going to start from scratch. I will show you how to start from scratch. And maybe you already have a website. Well, then you can skip a few parts. In the description of this video, I have timestamps. So if you want to go to a certain part of this tutorial, you can click on the timestamp and you will go directly to that part. And if I go too fast for you, you can click over here and you can slow down the speed of the tutorial. So let me show you the four steps we are going to take to create this amazing website with this booking system. If you're starting from scratch, I can show you how to get a domain name and web hosting, and I can give you 60% off discount. After that, we will install WordPress, then we will get the Astra theme and the Jet appointment plugin, and then we will create our amazing appointment booking system. And if you have a domain name and web hosting already and you have installed WordPress, then you can go to step 3 and I will show you the timestamp so you can go immediately to that point in the video. So I hope you like what you're seeing so far. If you like it, please like this video and feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials. And then I would like to say, let's get started. So the first two things we need in order to create a website are a domain name and web hosting. If you have this already, that's great. Then you can skip this part. If you don't have it, then you can go to webhostingfk.com. Hit enter. And you will be redirected to Name Hero. Name Hero is, in my opinion, the best web hosting provider there is. Why? Let me give you a few reasons. There are more, but one, your website will load fast, even if you go for the cheapest package. Why? Because Name Hero has invested in Lightspeed, which is way faster than Apache, which is used with a lot of different web hosting companies. Here you see an overview what the difference is when you use WordPress. The second one, the prices are really competitive. You get premium web hosting for an affordable rate, which is amazing. And the third one, really important, the support. You can call them 24/7. You can open a live chat 24/7 and you can leave a ticket and they will get back to you. So three ways to get support. And that's what I love about Name Hero. Now, one of the reasons you get such affordable prices here at Name Hero is because I get an exclusive discount for you up to 66% instead of the regular 50% that you get at Name Hero. And if you want to see what the plans are, click over here on this button or scroll down. And there are four packages: the Starter Cloud, the Plus Cloud, Turbo Cloud, and the Business Cloud. So what are the differences between those packages? With the Starter Cloud, you can start with one domain name. So if you're really on a budget, this is where you can start. You have one website, 1 gigabyte of RAM. It's just like your computer. The more RAM you have, the faster your computer will remain. Also, if you're doing a lot of things at the same time. So if you get a lot of visitors at the same time, then you can upgrade. But I'm talking about hundreds of visitors per day. You have unlimited SSD storage. What does it mean? You can have 250,000 files on your website, which is more than enough. You have free SSL. That means that you can make your website secure. With other web hosting companies, it can cost money. Here it is free, even with the Starter Cloud plan, and free website migration. So if you have a website already and you want to transfer it to NameHero, you can do that for free. Then we have the Plus Cloud. What is the big difference? Well, you have more a gigabyte of RAM, so more people can go to your website at the same time. And you can have up to 7 websites. And the great thing is, when you get this package, you can have 7 different domain names and all store them under one web hosting package. You get 60% discount. You pay $5.18 per month, and then you can have 7 websites. So that is less than $1 per website per month. So my opinion, if you're starting, get this package. And if you're really like, okay, money doesn't matter, I just want to go with the best of the best of the best, then I suggest you go for the Turbo Cloud. You can have unlimited websites, so you can even become a web design agency, start to make websites for clients and host them all on your website and charge them $20 per month for web hosting, depending on what you want to offer. And the great thing about this package is that your websites become even faster using NVMe storage, which is faster than SSD. So your website will go so fast. And the great thing is, those websites are already fast. This one becomes even faster. You have the Speed Boost plugin, and you will have a free domain, which is quite nice. And then if you're like, you know, I have too much money, I just want to get the best of the best of the best, then you can go for the Business Cloud. And then I'm talking like, if you have 50 websites hosting on NameHero, then I would go for the Business Cloud. The great thing is, you can always upgrade later. So you can start with the Plus Cloud, for instance, and then later go to the Turbo Cloud. Send them an email, they will fix it for you. What I want to do now, I want to start with a new website. So I want to start with the Plus Cloud. So the whole year, I can decide if I want to create a second website or a third one, and I don't pay anything extra except for the domain name. So in order to purchase it, I scroll down and I go to order now. And then we need to register a new domain name. Well, a domain name can be registered only once. So if I say I want to have facebook.com and I click on search, Facebook is unavailable. So you need to have a unique domain name, and I would like to go with FertiWP, Ferti WordPress. Then you can have .com. You can have a lot of different extensions. If you want to go international, I would go for .com. And you can go for your own country. So for instance, my country is the Netherlands. I can have this one, or the UK. Well, as you see, there are a lot of extensions over here. So there are so many, but I would go internationally for .com and or locally for your own country extension. And talking about names, if you want to start a new business, use that business name. If it's already taken, you can become creative with your name. I highly suggest you always have your own first and last name as a .com. You never know what you want to do in your life. And if you have it, you have it. So I go for FertiWP.com. I click on search, and it is available, and it's for free if I go for 2 or 3 years at once. So I click on continue. I'll explain that to you. Over here, we can choose our billing cycle. And the great thing is, the amazing discount of 60% will be applicable on the first invoice. So if you go for 1 year, you get 1 year of discount, 2 years of discount, or 3 years of discount. And the longer you go, the more extra discount you get, as you see, say 30% or 6%. So the longer you go, the cheaper it becomes. I want to go with 1 year. And then there are a few extra things we can take over here. Would you like to add dedicated IP address? Well, I don't need all these things. Auto encrypt is free. We don't need this one. So I click on continue. And then, really important, what we need is ID protection. It only costs less than $3 per year. And this will make sure that when you sign up, spammers that will see all the new websites in the world will not spam you with a lot of things like, hey, let me create a logo or do SEO or create a website for you, or they will call you. You don't want that. So if you use ID protection, they cannot see all your details. So click on continue. And the great thing is, this is crazy, the total amount we have to pay is less than $100. With other web hosting companies, really good ones also, you pay around $150, sometimes more, and here below $100. I really like it. We save a lot of money. And what we have the web hosting plus cloud, so we can have 7 websites, and we have our domain registration. And since I go for 1 year, I need to pay around $16 for it. But this is great. This is for 12 months of web hosting and a domain name. You can start your business for just $7 per month. So what I can do now, I can create a new account. So I will leave my details over here. That's not my name. This is my name, my last name, my email address, my phone number, and then my company name. I have a company with my wife and it's called Ferdin Anna Media. I'm from this address. So I need to fill in your details over here. How did you find us? Well, through YouTube, because I'm showing you. And then you have a support pin. If you want to call them or have a chat session with them, they ask for a pin, so you can leave it here and then they know you're really you. Now we need to create a password, of course, make it really secure, or you can generate one. And then you need to confirm your password. Then I scroll down and you can pay with credit card, PayPal, Coinbase, or credit card with Stripe. Well, I want to go with credit card, so I can leave my details over here. I scroll down. Do I want to receive emails for special savings? Well, there's a great thing. Well, every year there's Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and then they gave huge discounts for extending the service. So you can get some money on your Name Hero account, and then Name Hero adds extra money for you. So in that way, you have discount for the next invoice. And if you have written and agreed to the terms of service, you can check this. Keep in mind that when you got here through webhostingfk.com, you don't pay more, but you get extra discount and I get a commission. So I see that as a win-win situation. Name Hero will check all your details and see if there's no fraud. Well, if it's you that's filling in the information, then it should be fine. So I can go to the checkout and it says order confirmation, order is placed. If you have any questions about your order, please open a support ticket from your client area and quote your order number. I want to go to the client area. So I want to congratulate you. You have your own domain name and web hosting. That is amazing. And the great thing with Name Hero, your website is live immediately. The only thing is if you go to ferdiwp.com, it looks a little bit weird. So we need to install WordPress. But the great thing is it's not with all web hosting companies that your website is live immediately. If you want to install WordPress, you click over here on My Cloud, and then you click over here on Web Hosting Plus Cloud. Here we can log into the cPanel, and now we can install WordPress. We need to scroll down, or we search over here for WordPress, and there it is, WordPress Manager by Softaculous. Click on it, and then I click on Install. So we see the newest version of WordPress. Here we can choose our domain name. If you have more domain names, you can select one. And then here I want to select HTTPS, so our website will be secure from moment one. We need to remove WP, otherwise your website will be installed on your domainname.com/WP. No, you want it to be in the root directory. So people go to ferdiwp.com and then they go to my website. Here you can give your website a name and a site description. And you really need to do this now, otherwise, yeah, you can do this only once. No, just kidding. You can do this in the website. I will leave it for now and we will do it later in the website. Here we can choose a username, FerdiCorp for instance, and a beautiful password. Oh, hide. You can let it be created or create your own. Let's see if I can go stronger than 65. In real life, I'm not that strong, so I'd rather be strong on the internet with my password so I can say to people that I'm strong. Man, I'm so strong. And then your admin email, you need to have access to this email address. And then you can select your site language. You can install 2 plugins, the classic editor and the limit login attempts. And I don't need those. Need those. I click over here and I close it because it looks too complicated. This is all fine. You can trust them. This is all fine. And we don't need to install a theme. We will do that from within WordPress. And if you want to, you can send the email installation details to an email address, but I leave it as it is. I click on install. And there it is. Congratulations, the software was installed successfully. So if I would go to this link, you see that our website is live already and it is secure. That is amazing. It looks really bad, and that is what we're going to change, of course, in this tutorial. But it means you are live at this moment. 10 minutes ago, we bought web hosting and the domain name, and now we are live. That's amazing. So this is the front end of the website. Everybody that will see your domain or go there, hit enter, they will see your website. But we want to change the website. We want to configure things. And in order to do that, we need to go to the back end of the website. The website has a front end. That's what you will see, what the visitors will see. And there's a back end. And if you click over here, and then you'll see the back end. And right now you see it's not secure. And it can be that you also see that over here. That's the case. Sometimes it is secure, sometimes not. But in the end, everything will be secure. So in order to do that, you need to go to the back end. And before we do that, I want to talk about the back end a bit more. This is the place for the users, for you, to configure your website, to create new pages, upload images, PDFs if you want to, install plugins if you want to sell products on the internet or have a Facebook like box or whatever. All that can be done through the back end. And then there's the front end. That is what people see. So really important, the front end and the back end. And if I click over here, I go to the front end. And now, here you don't see that, but now you see a bar over here. That means that you're logged in. And when you're logged in, you can scroll down and you'll still see this bar. And you can add a new post, add a new page, add some media, add a new user. You can update things. You can customize the theme. We'll talk about that. And you can go back to the back end. So this we don't need anymore. So right now we have the back end. And if we click over here, we go to the front end. So let's talk about the back end. I click over here. And this is our dashboard, an overview with a lot of information. And then here at the left, we can have updates. And if I click over here, I scroll down, I see there are two themes that need an update. So I can select them, update those. So every time there is an update for a plugin or a theme or whatever, you can update it over here and you'll see it in the top bar. Then there's post. We can add new blog posts. We can add PDFs, videos, media, whatever, Word documents, and we can check them or we can add new ones. Well, then there are pages like the homepage, the about page. We can create those. If you have blog posts and people comment on it, you can see that over here. You can approve them or put them into the spam. Then there's the appearance. You can change the look and feel of your website using themes. We're going to talk about that. Then there are plugins, extra functionalities for your websites. You can make your website a web shop. Let's take a look. If I click on add new, you can add the classic editor, which is the old editor of WordPress. You can have anti-spam, make your website more secure. You can have a forum. You can have a social media website. All those things can be added to your website. Then there are users. You can add more users that can change the whole website, or you can add a user that only can add blog posts. So you can hire someone that will write blog posts for your website. Then you can export your website, import your website. And then there are the settings. We'll take a look at that in a second. You know what? Let's do it right now. Let's go to general in order to make our website secure. Add an S over here. That's everything you need to do. Over here and over here. Then you save it and then you need to log in again. But now it is secure. If I go to the front end, it is also secure. So that's great. What I want to do now, I want to start with a clean WordPress installation. So if I take a look over here, it's kind of overwhelming. So what I want to do, I want to remove everything we don't need and I want to start from scratch. So over here, I see I have one blog post. So if I click over here, I can bring it to the trash. Then I go to the trash over here and I can empty the trash. The same thing we can do at pages. I click over here, then I see all the pages. I click over here, so I select them all, bulk actions, move to the trash, apply. Then I go to the trash and I empty the trash. Okay, then we go to plugins. Two plugins, they're both deactivated. So if they're activated, you can select them both. Say bulk actions, deactivate them first. You need to deactivate them first before you can remove them, but they're both deactivated. So I click on delete. I don't need those two. Yes. Awesome. Then I want to go to the settings, general. We can scroll down. We can change the site language over here. The time zone meets plus one. We can change the date format. the time format. So if you want to have capital AM, you can do that. So I use this one. And the week starts for me on Monday. So I save the changes. That's awesome. Then I go to the permalinks. We're still cleaning up our website, making it look better. And we change this day and name to post name. Why? Right now, if I have a blog post, we went to Australia. It'll say your domain / the year, the month, the day. And then we went to Australia. And I'd rather have the post name. So it will say my domain name / we went to Australia. So that's better. And Google also likes it. And this is the worst. That when you go to a blog post, it will say this code. This is not good for the search results. One of the most important things to be found on the internet is your domain name and your URL. So post name. So if I search for how to make a forum, and I scroll, it says HostGator. It says create forum website. So it has three keywords in the URL. So you see, it's important to have a good post name over here. Save the changes. So whatever the title is in your blog post or in your page, that will be shown over here instead of this stupid code or the date, which is not necessary. Okay, let's go to the dashboard. I want to clean it up a little bit. I can collapse everything. Or even better, I can click over here on the screen options and remove everything. This looks so much better in my opinion. And then I see over here, this area, Ferdy Corp. I want to add my user. I can do that over here, or I go to users profile. And then I can change the look and feel of my backend. So if you see something you like, you can use that. I like the default one. And then I scroll down. I want to enter my first name. I want to enter my last name. I can have a nickname. I can change it. And here the display name publicity. Right now it says Ferdy Corp. So if I have a blog post, it will say this is written by Ferdy Corp. Well, I'd rather have Ferdy Corpus Hook, my full name. And now it says howdy Ferdy Corpus Hook. That is better. And I want to see an image over here. So you need to have a Gravatar account. So right now I have ferdycorp@gmail.com. And then I have a profile picture over here. So right mouse click. Open a new tab. Over here, I can sign in for free and I can upload an image, and that image will be linked with the email address you use over here when you sign in. And if you use the same email address within your WordPress website, then that image will appear. So I have an account over here. It's linked to info@ferdycorpushook, as you see. So if I grab this, copy, and I paste it here in my contact info email, that means that my Gravatar account will be linked to this WordPress website. So if I update it and I need to confirm it, now you see this image, which is linked to this email account. So you can sign up really easily for Gravatar, and then your profile picture will be seen over here. Then there's a text you can have about yourself. So if you write blog posts and there's an area with about the author, this text will appear. I make websites for a living and I love to help people to achieve more in life, something like that. You can set a new password and you can update your profile. So if I go over here to the backend, it looks clean, no unnecessary stuff. And if I take a look at the front end, it still looks ugly. We're going to make it better. And the way we can do that is with themes. What is a theme? A theme decides how your website will look. It will define the look and feel of your website. And every theme has their own settings. So if I would go to the backend and I go to appearance themes, I can choose a different theme, for instance, 2019. Now it's activated. So if I go to the website, it is with the same information, the title and the subtitle, a recent blog post, those widgets, but the look and feel is different. And that's what a theme does. And besides that, it has extra functionalities. Now there is a great theme, which has amazing capabilities. In order to get it, we can go to ferdycorp.com/Estra. It's the Estra theme. It's a free theme. And the great thing with this theme, it comes with a lot of extra functionalities. There is a pro version, but in this video, I want to focus on the free version. So you can click on download, And then you go to the pricing page, then you need to scroll down all the way, all the way, all the way, all the way. And then can decide which plan is right for you. Download the free Astra theme. Then you can leave your details. If you don't want to do that, you can close this and you can go to the dashboard to appearance themes. Click on add new and search for Astra. It's also here within WordPress. There it is, the purple one. Astra install now. And activate it. It has a lot of installation already. I think a few million. I'm not sure, but it's the most popular theme. And then we're going to make use of starter templates. Why? Probably you already have a website. In this tutorial, I want to focus on creating an appointment booking system. And it can be that you already have a website. And if you want to learn how to create a website from scratch, then I suggest you go to YouTube. By the way, I will talk about changing things in the website, but if you want to get an in-depth tutorial on how to make a website from scratch without a booking system, and in this tutorial, we'll focus on the booking system, then you can search for WordPress 30/2021, for instance, unless it's 2022. With Elementor Pro, but I'm talking about this video here, I will show you step by step. Don't click here. No, Daryl's a good guy. He has a lot of subscribers. I hope one day I will have more subscribers than him. I started earlier and there was a time I had 8,000 subscribers and he had 4,000, but he has amazing tutorials, but just saying that. Tyler, also a great guy. Actually, all those people are great guys, except for this one. No, just kidding. So that's what you can do. What we will do, we will install a pre-made website. So select the page builder. I use Elementor. And now we can install a complete website. And that's the great thing about Astra. That's what I mean with the extra functionalities. Every theme has their own. And this is what I love about Astra. It's a big team with people that have great support and they want to help you to make websites fast. So we select the free one. And then we can select something. And for instance, let me give you a few examples of what you can do with a booking appointment website. You can become a life coach or a team of life coaches, and then you can use the booking plugin to have life coach sessions. So people can, so you can have different services like a business talk and motivation and personal growth. I don't know. You can add different services that people can book with you. And when they book it, they can choose whom they want to talk to. So you can have a team of 5 life coaches, and then they can select which life coach they want to talk with. Piano lessons. They can book piano lessons, and then you can say, you know what, not only piano lessons, what service do you want to have? Piano lessons or guitar lessons or drumming lessons. And with every service they choose, they can choose their own tutor. And they can have a website with showing all the tutors, with making videos about what every tutor can do, and then people can choose. So that's what you can do with the booking plugin we're going to use. What else? If you have a yoga website, this one, for instance, you can have different yoga lessons. I don't know if there are different yoga lessons. Probably I see 6 already over here. And every lesson can have their own instructor, or people can choose. So to give you an example, as you have seen in the intro, this is how it looks. You can choose a service. Then you can choose people attached to that service, and we're going to set it up all from scratch in this tutorial. And what I want to do, I want to have a barbershop. So I scroll down a bit further, and there it is, a barbershop. So I can click over here so I can see what it is. It has a homepage, an about page, the barbers, the gallery, and the contact page. Well, I like it. So I want to import the complete website. And it says your selected website is being imported. You can delete previously imported sites, but it's the first one. So I click on import and I import everything. So I now need to wait so I can take a sip of water. And now it's being imported. Really nice guys at Astra. I met the founder of Astra, the creator. Really nice guy. And they are doing their best to give you the best so you can make websites fast. And of course, they have a free version because they hope you like it. And then you can upgrade to the pro version if you want that. If I have tutorials about all the pro versions, all pro version features. So Astra Pro 30, or you can go to 30corp.com But in this tutorial, we'll focus on the free version. But if you want to, you can go to Estra. And then I have a complete tutorial. I will make a new one this week because they upgraded things again. And then about all those different beautiful things of Estra. So, and I saw something like people seem to absolutely love it. So, meanwhile, it's imported and I want to view the site. And again, I import this site because I want to focus on creating a booking system within this website. And I guess you already have your website. So I close this. I close this and this is our website. So in the beginning of the tutorial, I send people to this point of the video in the video if they already have a website. And if they already have their web hosting, you cannot have a website without web hosting. So I mean the other way around. If you already have web hosting and you have a website, this is the point where you begin. So you have your website. It can be about barbers. It can be about yoga lessons, about life coaching, about any service. It can be about bachelor parties. And this is the final result, what we are going to create, but it's not limited to being a barbershop. You know, you can offer any service and attach any person to that service. You can even let them pay immediately using Stripe. So when they book the service, and the person, they have to pay immediately and it will go to your bank account. That's what you can do. And that's what I will show you how you can do that. So are you guys ready? What we're going to use in order to do this is a CrocoBlock subscription. In order to get it, you can go to ferdycorp.com/CB. That stands for CrocoBlock. And there we go. And if I go to products, I can search for a Jet Appointment. That's the plugin that we're going to use. Look at this. So here you see, you can have three services, haircut, manicure, or makeup. What kind of service if you want to, and then the stylist, choose someone you would want to do your styling and stuff. And when do you want to do it? And on with which time slot do you want to do it? And then you can leave your details and you can pay immediately, or you can pay in the store when you get the service. Or if you do that, you can choose a payment option and you can add it to your calendar. That's what we're going to talk about in this tutorial. Oh, you can do this for, buy this for $19, but it's not entirely true because you need to buy this in a set. So let's go to the set. You also need Jet Engine and a few of other plugins. So let's talk about pricing. And before we do that, I want to go to my WhatsApp. I had a friend who called me a few weeks ago saying, hey, I want to create something like this, an appointment thing for a bachelor party service. How can I do that? And I said, you know what? I will make a tutorial about it soon. And then yesterday I sent him a message. Where is he? And I sent him a video like, hey, this is what I'm going to make. Is this something for you? So let me go to the Dutch to English translation. You think, why am I telling you this? Well, I'll show you. Hi, Ferdy. First of all, it's great that you think about me for a moment. We are certainly still working on it, but I had found someone who wanted to do all this stuff, make an appointment website or a plugin for 1200 euros. So chose that, but to talk to him about it. Super thanks. So if I search for 1200 euros to dollars, it's around $1450. Wow. So the great thing is when you know how to create something like this, and I will show you step by step in the tutorial how you can do that, you can make money with it. So what are the pricing plans? Well, if you want to go for a dynamic website and you want to use it for only one website, so you have one client, you can buy this option for $85. You can follow along in this tutorial. You get Jet Engine, which you need, Jet Appointment, which you need. Let me see if there's also pop-ups. Yes, that's also included. So that's what you can do. So for $85, you can start. But what I suggest you do, I just told you, you can make $1,450 with making this for a client. And I will show you step by step how you can do this. So after watching this tutorial, you can do that. I have a lifetime all-inclusive subscription. What does it mean? I can use it for unlimited websites. And I only paid $750 at once. And I did not pay this amount, but I paid $300 because they're upgrading this package, this suite of plugins every time. And they make it, making it more expensive because it's getting more valuable. But I still have it. and I only pay $300. So if you want to take this serious, I suggest you go for this one. You can also go for this one, or if you want to start with one website, $85, but there's a chance that the lifetime version or this will become more expensive. So if you would go with the all-inclusive lifetime version, you can click over here. You can pay it over here, next step, and then pay it with PayPal or with credit card or whatever. Or again, you can use the $85 version. It's all up to you. And when you have done that, you can go to your account. And as you see over here, I paid $299, a little bit longer than a year ago. So it's now 100% more expensive, but it's still worth it. It's such an amazing tool. And not only that, what I will do to give something back to you, I will create tutorials about all these plugins. So if you take a look at tutorials at 30corp.com, so go to 30corp.com. Sorry, I went a little bit fast. Hit enter. Then you go over here to tutorials, CrocoBlock. Here I show you what you can do with CrocoBlock, but there are Jet Elements, more elements for Elementor, Jet Tricks. I will teach you about all these amazing things. So you can make hotel booking websites, you can make car rental websites, you can make it look so professional, and you can use it all in combination with the free version of Elementor. And that's also what I will do. I will not use Elementor Pro or any other paid plugin, only this one. I want to search for Jet Engine. Jet Engine over here, I click on download. Then I scroll up, you need to close your eyes. I want to use my license key, copy it, I close the page to plugins, add new, upload a plugin, and I drag Jet Engine over here. I click on install now. I want to activate the plugin, and it will also activate CrocoBlock over here. So right now I see CrocoBlock, then I want to go to license, and I close this. And then I want to paste my license. So I click on add new, paste it, activate the license. Awesome. Awesome. So now I see an overview of all the Jet plugins that come with CrocoBlock, and I want to install a few more. So I have Jet Engine, which I need for the appointment plugin. And what I also want is the appointment, Jet Appointment plugin. And I want to have the Jet Theme Core plugin. And I want to have Jet Pop Up. So over here, install. I think that's it. And again, I will have tutorials about all these plugins. Then I need to activate the plugins. And when they're activated, you see them in their color. Right now they are gray. Activate them. And the latest one, activate. So I've been playing around with this for a long time to learn step by step how it works. And I'm really excited that I can show you step by step how it works, so it will save you a lot of time. I digged really deep, and now I can show you how it is done, so you can save a lot of time. And by the way, if you bought it, congratulations. It's a really good choice. If I could buy only one premium thing for my WordPress websites, it would be CrocoBlock. But I'm happy that I don't have to keep it at one thing. I also have Astra Pro, Divi Theme, Elementor Pro, all amazing tools to make amazing websites. So right now, if I take a look over here, I have my barbershop. And now I want to implement a booking system. Well, I see some information over here. There are a few barbers here, and I want to use their names and their images. And I want to use their services. So there's a mustache expert, a beard trimmer, a hair specialist. And what I can do, I can use this pricing if I want to in the booking system. And now we're going to create our booking system. So what we will do, we will create two things using Jet Engine. Right now you see posts over here and you see pages. And what we're going to do, we're going to create two custom post types. What are that? It can be anything. It can be houses. It can be listings. It can be people. It can be services. So in this case, I want to build a team, show a team over here. So how can I do that? I go to Jet Engine and I go to Post Types. And I can add a new one, and I will show you step by step how you can do this. And if you have a question, please leave it in the comment and I will do my best to help you. And if you have CrocoBlock, there's also help for you. So you can go to the help center, submit a ticket, and you can even feature a request. So if you like, hey, this is really nice, but I'm missing something, well, then you can send a feature to them. So that's amazing. They're really nice to help you to make beautiful websites. And I want to create my first post type. Add new. And this one is called team. Or no, barbers. Yeah, even better. Then I say tap. I don't say it, but I do it on my keyboard and then it will create a slug over here. Then I want to go to the advanced settings. I scroll all the way down until I see this over here, the menu icon, because this is what will appear over here at the left from barbers, because barbers will appear over here. So let's click here and I can search for barbers or a knife. So let me see what fits. I can find an icon. So it's just for myself. It's not for people, visitors on my website, just for myself for reference. So if I see something I think that fits, I can use it. Well, since we're talking about barbers, we're talking about more people. So maybe this one. And then over here at supports, a title, an editor, and I want to have a third one, which is a thumbnail. So every barber can have a thumbnail. Okay, I want to add the post type, and what will happen here at the left? I will see barbers. So here I see an overview, or I can add a new barber. Well, I want to create a new post type. So I scroll down again to Jet Engine, post types. I want to add a new one. And the second one is services. So services, tap, do the same thing. Go to advanced settings, scroll down till I see this menu icon and the services. Also for my own reference, maybe something like this. So that's it. I'm happy with it. And then over here also, just in case, a featured image. Add the post type. So over here at the left, I have services and I have barbers. And I want to add a few services. If I want to take a look at the service I offer, I click over here. I hold command or control on the PC. I scroll down. And says haircuts, shaves, beard trim, and mustache trim. So why not do those? And over here at the barbers, there are a few barbers over here. So I can use those also as barbers. So before I do that, I want to change the title of my website, because over here it's professional barbershop since 1985. So I want to go to the settings in general. And I say over here at the site title, professional barbershop since 1985. Or I can say barbershop and then New York or whatever you are, because a barber is a local business. I don't think people fly over the world to go to a barbershop. So I would definitely say barbershop New York. So if people search for a barbershop in New York, you can come up in the search results. New York, York barbershop, and it's without a space. So I guess I should do the same. And maybe because New York is really big, you can say Manhattan or somewhere else, make the area a bit smaller so you can find the right customer. Okay, in order to add a few services and barbers, I can do it the fast way. By going over here to the website, go to the customizer. Then I want to go to menus. This is a small trick which enables me to create this all faster. I click on add items. I scroll to barbers or to services first. And over here I say hair cut. Add. The only thing is we'll also be added to the menu, so we'll need to remove that. What else do we offer? Haircuts. Haircut. Shaving. I like to keep it in singular form, so no plural. Beard trim also sounds singular. Trim. And a mustache trim. Okay. Awesome. Then I go to the barbers. Well, let's take a few cool names. The first one is Gregory. The second one, Klaas. No, no Klaas. That's a Dutch name. Edward. Oh, his name is there. Edward. So let's say Edward. And the third one, Roy. So I was close. Thomas, Gregory. Ah. Third one is Roy. They also have their own specialty. So beard, mustache, and hair. Okay. I think that's it. So I need to get rid of this, all those services. You see it's service and then barbers. Only three. Well, you can add as many as you want as long as you have those people that can cut hair for people. So I go back, and now when we take a look at the back end, we go to services. Looks like that. And we go to the barbers. If I go to Gregory. I don't see the name, but I need to select it over here. And I can say Edward. I don't see it, but blind typing. And then over here, I copy it and I change the slug back to Edward with small capitals. Or by the way, it will do that automatically. Update. So we have Edward, Thomas, and how can I forget your name? I'm so sorry. Roy. My best friend's name was Roy. It's still Roy, but it's not my best friend anymore. So Roy. Okay, let's not talk about Roy anymore. A lot of memories come up. Oh, good times playing soccer and stuff. Okay. Yes. Okay. We have the service and we have the barbers. What do we want to do now? We want to connect those with Jet Engine. So we have services and we have barbers. And what we want to do, we want to create a button on our website. Let's close this and close this. That says book an appointment and then, okay, what do you want? And then there are the four services. And after we choose a service, we see the barbers we want to choose. So in order to set it up, we need to scroll down over here. We need to go to appointments and over here to set up. So there are two things. First, we have the service. And the service, of course, is the services. Then I want to add the provider. So who provides the service? In this case, it's the barber. But it can be the yoga instructor. It can be the life coach. It can be the bachelor party leader. I don't know. It can be anything. The sky is not even the limit. It's even beyond that. The provider, post type, barbers. Next. Okay. By default, there will be an ID, a status, a service provider, user, date, slot, slot end, an order ID, and a user ID. If you want to, you can add more information and store that into your website and into your email. I want to add two more. The first one is the phone. And the second one, are there any comments or instructions? Comments. And then I click on next. Okay, the working hours. Well, we can see that on the website, if I'm correct. When are they opened? Okay. Monday till Friday from 9 to 5 p.m. From 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Okay, so we're going to do that. On Monday, they're open from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. I always think after 30, 40 minutes, you're so far in this tutorial, so I feel a little bit more freedom to do whatever I want. If I would do this in the first minute of the video, you will probably go to my competitor. That's my worst nightmare. But now, since you're here, I guess you will stay so I can sing. please do not remove your like from my video. And if you have not liked it, please like it. So 9 to 5, Thursday. And you can also say, we work from 9 to 12, save it. And then we add one more from 12 till 12:30. We have lunch. So from 12:30 until 5. So you have a break in between 12 and 12:30. That's what you can do. It's, you can do it. Friday, I think it's the same. From 9 till 5. Save it. And then on Saturday, there were different times. 11 till 3. Saturday from 11 until 3. Save it. Okay, and Sunday they are closed. So Sunday we add nothing. Well, then there are a few days they are not working. So which day? Christmas, which is, I think, December 24th and the 25th. Save it. And another day where my wife is, this is her birthday, my wife, I don't know, birth, national, Anna Day, that's the name of my wife. It's the 3rd of March. Okay. Working days. Well, those are the working days. And then really important, the default time slot length. So how long do people take for the haircut? Well, 30 minutes should be doable, especially Gregory, who's not there. I mean, Thomas, he's really good. So really important, again, a lot of important things. Do we want to integrate this with WooCommerce? Well, with a barbershop, you may almost always pay after you get the haircut locally in the store. So you don't have to integrate, but what you can do, you can let people pay upfront, and then you need to check this. We'll talk about it later. And over here, we create a single service booking form and a sample page booking form. What's the difference? Over here, we have 4 services and we can have 4 pages about every service, subpage or page about it. And then on that page, we can have a single service booking form. That means that on the haircut page, we can post a haircut booking form. So you cannot choose a different service than haircutting, only haircutting. With this form, you can select one of the 4 services. So even if you're on the haircut page, you can still have the option to go for a mustache. So I want to go for the sample page booking form. So I turn this one off and then I click on finish. So a form will now be created. We do not use WooCommerce yet, but it's really easy to do that. I will show you in this tutorial how you can do that. Now we can go to the plugin settings in a new tab. I don't know why. And it's actually the same place as appointments and settings. So over here, we can go to all the posts, the services, our services, the providers are the barbers. There's no WooCommerce integration. We do not manage the capacity. There it is. Slot time format. How do you want to display it, with PM and AM? Well, since they do it over here with AM and PM, let's do the same. Working hours. Here you can change it a little bit, make it longer, make it shorter. There can be a 15 minutes of break, but I don't need that. Or after the time, maybe you have a service where people need to clean up things. So when after people book for 30 minutes, you need 50 minutes in order to clean things up. So if your first appointment can be at 10 o'clock, then the second appointment will be at 10:45. And if you say 0, it will be at 10:30. So that's why the buffer before and after is there. Here we can adjust everything. We can work with custom labels. If you have a different language in your website, you can make it a different language over here. January, February, March, April, all that stuff. Well, I don't need that. Then there's advanced availability check. Yeah. If 10,000 people are on your website at the same time and they want to book at the same time, it will keep track of who was there first and who can choose a time slot first. You can hide the setup wizard if you're making this website for a client. There's a setup over here, and if you go there, you can reset it. And you don't want the client to mess up. So you can go to the settings and to advanced or to tools. No, advanced, and turn this off. And the great thing with CrocoBlock settings, they almost save automatically. So now it's, if I refresh the page, at appointment here, it is gone. Okay, awesome. And then we can have tools. Well, those were the extra things I added over here. So far, so good. What we can do now? We can go to, first let me go to the barbers. I go to Edward. Let me check Edward over here. Edward is this guy. So I want to add an image over here. So featured image. Let me search for Edward over here. I can update it. I can go back by clicking on the WordPress icon. Then I go to, whoa, there are two Edwards. Whoa. Let's change this one into Thomas. Copy, tap, paste. Then I click on Thomas. And I search for Thomas over here. This is Thomas, a really good guy. And then the third one is Roy with an amazing looking eye. It looks like he has a really big pupil. Pupil, is that the word? But yeah, also a really nice guy. So Roy, set the featured image, select Roy. Awesome, update. Okay, what we can do, we can also do the same with the services. Haircut. I saw a few nice icons. Maybe we can add those. The haircut is this one. Yeah, let's do that, man. Awesome. Are you guys still having fun? I hope so. Let's go to shaving. This one. Update. If you want to fast forward, close this, you can open things holding command and they will open in a new tab. And then you can, let me see the beard trim. It's the third one. And then there's the fourth one, the mustache trim. Update. So now everything and every service has an image attached to it. And now we can go to the forms, Jet Engine forms. And we only have a static page booking form. And what does it mean? This is the one of the two forms we can choose. And this form will show you all the options there are when you open this form. So you can choose one of the four services, haircut. So what I want to do now, I want to start simple. So I go to the website holding command or control on the PC. I edit the page with Elementor. Before we do that, sorry, let me go back to CrocoBlock. Jet plugins, no, updates and installations. I want to add one more, Jet Elements. Click on install. Yeah, it's for later. I want to activate the plugin. So again, I go to the website, I click on edit with Elementor. And what I can do, I can drag the form we have somewhere in our website. Anywhere, as long as it is within Elementor. So if you take a look at the result, click on the eye. Over here, we can have it. So let's do that. Just see how it looks. I can search for form. And over here it is. I drag it with the green button. I drag it over here. You see nothing yet because we need to select a form. And I call this page, or I search for page because it's called static page booking form. And there it is. the service, the provider, the date, and the email, and we can book now. Okay, if I click on update, that means over here it will refresh automatically. This is our form. And let me state that this is the beginning of our form. We're going to style it. We're going to make it beautiful. We're going to trigger it with a button so we get a pop-up sliding from the right. We'll add faces over here. We'll make it look so much better, but we need to start somewhere. And step by step, I want to show you how it works. So this is what we already have done. So let's start over here. I click over here on the column settings. And before I continue, I want to change a few things. Over here, I click on the three lines. I go to the user preferences, change the user interface theme to dark. And I want to edit or add editing handles. So we have a little bit more options. I click on update. I click over here. I go to the style, go to the background, and I want to make it black and transparent. Then I want to go to advanced. I go to padding and I hit the arrows up. So there's a little bit more space over here. Update. When we update it, we see the result immediately over here. So let's do this. I want to select the beard trim. And there's no one I can select. Why is that? Well, we need to link the providers, the barbers, to the service. Oh, step by step, we're going to do everything. So if I go to the services, I can do two ways. I can go to the services. Let's update this. I can go to the services and I can attach haircutters. So if there's an haircut service, who can do this? Well, over here, I can select the barbers. Edward can do this. And Roy can do this. But maybe Thomas cannot do this. So I leave Thomas over here. My son is crying, so I will stop the recording and continue in a few seconds. Okay, my son is sleeping now. So we can continue. So what I said, two of the three people can do haircuts and Thomas is into the mustache thing. So I go back to the shaving. Of course, Thomas can do that. Actually, everybody can do it. So Thomas, and Roy, and Edward. Okay, the third one. And again, we can speed this up by opening them both in a new tab. This one is only Roy. Roy is the expert in doing the beard. So only Roy can do that. And the other one can be done only by Edward and Thomas. So that's how it is done now. And if you go to the barbers, you click on one, Edward, you see what he can do. So you see the other way around. He can do three of the four services, haircut, shaving, and the mustache. So no beard trimming. So in that way, you can give everybody their own specialty. And now when we go to the website, refresh, I can select a beard trim. Then based on the service, I can select only Roy. But if I select shaving, I can select all three of them. If I select haircut, only Edward and Roy. So in that way, you can assign people to a service. Then I can choose a date. Today only from this time on. So this for today. This starts in 2 minutes. I can use my email and I can book now. If I do that, I see over here that the form is successfully submitted. Of course, we can make this look better, of course. Right now, if I go to the backend, that's handy for the owner of the website. If I go to appointments, I see I have an appointment that is pending. with the user email, and then I can click on edit. I can change the pending to completed. And then it gets an email like it's confirmed that you can be there in 1 minute, because that's in 1 minute. It's January the 20th, 1 minute before 1 p.m. So since I've already taken 1 p.m., if I would do the same thing now, a haircut with Edward, this time slot will be removed. So in that way, you can fill up your whole day with haircuts, because the more slots are taken, the less will show. So I really like this way of making an appointment website. So you can do the same with counseling, or how do you say that? A life coach sessions. Maybe you want to speak to people over Skype, and people can book you, and you can say, you know what, I'll have every day 3 slots. And if 2 slots are taken, only 1 is available. And in that way, you can fill up your agenda with a service you provide. Nice. So we've done quite a bit already, but now I want to focus more on what else we can show over here. So I go back to the backend, and I go to Jet Engine Forms. And there it is. I click on it. And what we added before is 2 extra functions or 2 extra information items. The first one is the phone number, and the second one is a comment. Maybe someone has an instruction. So I want to add a field over here by clicking here. I can drag it up so the submit button is below, and then here I can change it. So text, it is text, and it's okay. And I can say phone number, and over here the label says phone. It is required, and I don't need a placeholder, and I apply the changes. Awesome. Then the second one, also text area, field underscore comment. Here I say comment. Here I do want to have a placeholder. I say it's not required. If you have a comment, you can place it here. Apply the changes. Again, drag this one down. Update. Now, if I refresh this page, what you'll see here below, user email, phone, and comment. If you have a comment, you can place it here. So we can do a few things. We can style this to make it look better. We can change the text. And we can also put it into a pop-up. So when you click over here, then at the left or at the right, whatever you want, will appear this area. And we can break it down. And one thing else we can do, we can create listings you can create listings for every selection. So over here right now, we can select those 4 options. But we can create something in Elementor, which makes it more visual. So if I go to local, Estra and booking, this is where I practice. We can make it look like this. I click over here. This is the wrong one. As you see, sometimes things go wrong. That's the whole part of doing this. A lot of things go wrong, but finally I managed to make it work. So right now it looks like this, book an appointment. So that looks different than this. So I select this one, then I can select a person, then I can select the date. It's all styled in the colors of our website. Click on next, user, phone, and the amount you have to pay. So that's what we can make. And that's what we're going to build, something like this. So we're not there. We're halfway there. We're doing great. So thank you for that. So step by step, we're going towards that, but this is already great. So first things first, there's so much I want to talk about, but let's go back to the form over here. And then I want to go to the service. I open them all in a new tab, holding command or control on a PC. And then on a Mac, I say control tab. I go to the next area. I scroll down, and here you see a price per slot. So let me go to the website. I've seen the prices. Or we can create our own prices, of course. Okay. Let's create our own prices. Hair, $35. Update. Let's go to the next one. beard treatment, $50. So shaving, okay, shaving can be cheaper, 15. Then we have the beard trim, 40. Yeah, no, 30. And then the latest one is the mustache. Oh, that's a different cookie, also 35. Of course, it actually doesn't matter exactly. So now if I refresh this, nothing changes. Beard trim, we can select Roy, we can select Thursday, pick a time slot. And I want to show the price over here. How can I do that? Well, I go back to the backend, then I go to Jet Engine, forms, the only form we have. Okay. And then I want to add a field. I drag it over here, click over here, and I want to have a calculator. Calculated. Then the name is underscore total. And now we need to calculate the formula. And you see some things over here. You need to grab this one, copy it, paste it, and then say asterisk one. If you're not sure it's the right one, you can go to ferdycorp.com, tutorials, Croco block. Scroll down and over here, grab this code. Since we're here, okay, leave this open because we're going to download a pop-up soon. Okay, here below, decimals 2, calculate the value prefix. So I can say a total of dollars and then, and then the price will appear. I click on apply changes. Update. Okay, let's see how it looks. The total is not available yet. Maybe after we choose the beard trim and select Roy, price is nothing. Okay, so we need to select the day and then the time, and then it will appear a total of $30. Then I click on book now. Of course, we need to fill the information. Okay, we have done it already. What we also can do, okay, we will do it later. Okay, so this works. So yeah, what I want to do now, I want to break this down into three parts. First, I want to select the service, then the provider, then and I want to break it into four parts. How can I do that? I go to the back end, close all this stuff except for this one. Then I go to forms. I want to add a few breaks into the form. How can we do that? Over here at the left, it says add a page break. So after the first option, select the service. We have a page break. Then select the barber. I want to have another page break. Then after selecting the date, I want to have another page break. So on the last page, you see your phone number details and the total amount. So if I click on update and I say command or control click, it's just this. Select it, next. Select provider, next. Select the date and the time, next. And then that looks better, don't you think? It's less overwhelming. Four steps, leave your email address, your phone, and a comment if you want to, and the total price, and then book now. Okay, we can change a few things. So at the appointment provider, I don't like to say provider. I would like to say select a barber. And the A, without a capital. Apply the changes. You need to apply the changes first and update it then. If you change a few things and you click on update, those changes will not be applied because you need to click on apply first. So now if I refresh it, we select the service and then we select the barber. Select the barber. Yes. So, okay, that's one thing to do it. Now I want to create a pop-up. So we go over here to ferdycorp.com and to tutorials Croco Blog, and then over here at Jet Appointment, I click on download the pop-up. Then I unzip it. And there it is. Pop-up style reference.json. Okay, before we import it, I'll show how you can create it yourself. So we go to Jet Pop-up, create a new pop-up. And I will call this one Booking Form Pop-up. Publish. And then we can edit it with Elementor. And you get a default one first. I want to show you as much as possible so I can import this pop-up, but I also want to show you how you can create this yourself. Okay. So let's go to the settings here left below. And here are the settings. Animation. I want it to fade or to slide in from the right. Like that. Open event. No, nothing. Okay, this is all fine. Then we can go to the style, the pop-up container. I can change the width to, let's say 560. Okay, custom height, and that will be in percentage 100%. I want to align it horizontally at the right and vertically at the center, the current position is at the top. I can have a background if I want to, but actually I'm happy. I can have a border radius. So you see, it looks like this, or have a padding or margin. Oh, we'll take a look at margin later. I don't think I need it. I don't need any border radius. Close button. Right now you probably don't see it, but it's there. And there is a style also, and here you can change the size. So now you see the X over there. Okay. And then below, I can transformation. Yes. Bring it to the left. And bring it some more to the left. So how about minus 400 or 500 or 600? Now we see it, we can make it smaller again. Okay. What I prefer to do is to work with the colors of the website. So I click at color, font color over here, and I use the primary color. This is not good. Click here over here, icon styles. The font color should be white, but the background color should be the primary one. Okay, that's the case. I bring it a bit back. Let's say minus 590 or 70, 60, 65, like that. And then over here, bring it a bit lower. That is okay. Just zero. Okay, so this is the area that will pop up when we trigger it with a button in our website. I click on update, and now we need to create the content. So I want to start over here with a section with one column. I go back, I go for a heading, and I say book an appointment. You don't see it? But what we can do, we can click over here. Go to the style, go to the background type, choose a primary color. Okay, then I click over here again, I go to the style, go to typography. I like to use Railway. You can choose your own font or the default font. Make the size a bit smaller. Okay, bring it to the center. Let me see, content, center. And then over here, advanced, I want to uncheck this and uncheck this. Okay, book an appointment. Sounds great. I can change the height of the section. Minimum height to 80. So you can create everything pixel perfect. Again, I can go to the settings over here, go to style, pop up container, make this 0. So it will be totally like this. Better. Update. So now over here, I click on the new section. And now I want to add a form. So I click over here, I search for form, and there we are again, this area. I drag it over here. Then I need to select the only form we have. So I click on page, and there it is. So we can select it, click on next, and then etc. So and now we can style this. Look at this. There are so many settings. Rows, fields, all those things. And if you open it, all those options. So we can walk through them all. But what we can also do, go back to the dashboard, go to pop-ups. I want to click on import pop-up, choose a file. I go to my downloads, pop-up reference, open it, import now. Then we immediately open it. And then I can click over here. And here all the styling is done already. And I made use a lot. So what I can do, I can say right mouse click, copy. Then I close this. I go to all pop-ups. And I go to our book form plugin or pop-up. Edit with Elementor. I know it's a little bit maybe dry, lecture stuff, maybe a little bit boring, but we need to know how it works. And then over here, right mouse click, paste the style. So you see, it will look different. Only thing we need to do now, adjust the colors to the colors of our website. So in order to do that, this is the style of our website. I see the color red over here, so I can pick that color. Copy it. I use the color pick eyedropper, a Chrome extension. I have a tutorial about it. And then over here, I go to the style. Actually, everywhere you see that darker color, click over here, go to the site settings, global colors, and then the first one, this color. And then let me see if there's a different color that they use. No, not really. We can create one. So I can paste it again and then I can make it lighter, or I can slide it down a bit, or a totally different color. Well, I want to maintain it a little bit in the same style. Like that. So I close this. And then I click here, I go to the style, and everywhere I see a color green, I change to the primary one. And everywhere there is a hover, I can go for the accent color. Probably by now that should already be selected, because I thought in my, you see all the text is changing over here. I don't know, I thought it would already link to the global color, but maybe it doesn't work like that. So as you see, there's a lot you can change. group breaks, no colors, required mark. We'll take a look at this later. It looks maybe a little bit weird, those colors of the calendar. So later I will change all those colors. You can also use secondary colors. We'll take a look at it later. For now, I will leave it as this. And if I would go to the submit, then this color will change. So right now, primary, hover, accent. Here, next page. If I change this, the background color, it will be red. And if I go to the hover, it will be accent, this color, and then that is what happens. What we also could do, since it's a dark website, we can go over here to the style settings and make the background dark. But that's up to you. I think it is better for the style of the website, but then I don't like this area. Okay. What I can do then. Okay. We're going to do this. Yes. Click over here. I can keep the colors. I go to the fields. I just try to reason like, okay, this is a field. Okay. I go to the area field, color of the text. Okay. The padding. If I go to the left, it's really close. I can increase it over here. I think there will be a template that has already done this. How about 14? And I think that the text can also be bigger like that. There's a bottom border. I don't like that. So over here I say 0. So it's gone. Okay. But padding, a little bit more space over here is not a bad idea. Okay. Let me see if I increase this. What happens? Maybe that arrow goes to the left. No. Keep that 5. I can have a radius. I can have a box shadow. I don't need that. Okay, then I go to the next button because I don't want to have the border. So I go to the next page button. And there probably is a border. And then say 0. Yes. So that's how it works sometimes. You just need to figure out how it works, play around with it. I think the padding is really big, but 15 by 10. I also should do the same with the previous page. Although, okay, let's see. So what I can do now, I can try it out. Beard trim, click on next. Select the barber, Roy, click on next. And if I select the service, it becomes blue. So there's a small error now. So I refresh the page. Or if you prefer, you can go back. Go to the other pop-up, the imported one, edit with Elementor. Click over here and then select the form. That's everything you need to do. Page. So it looks like this. When you select it, it gets a different color. So that's also what you can do. And you can save a lot of time, and then you need to change all the colors. So yeah, I will go back and let's take a look at what is next. I go to the website. I click on edit with Elementor. And I want to add the trigger button. So I don't need this anymore. Or the background color. I and get rid of it. But instead, first I want to decrease the height over here. Then this button, I get rid of it. And I go over here to all the buttons and I search for a button or all the elements. I need to have the green one. Okay. And I can have an icon if I want to. I can say book an appointment. And then I should use the same typography, default one. Okay. So it's style. Label. Typography should be default. That's okay. I make it uppercase. I want to go to the plane, to the colors. Background type. This color. When I hover over it, I change it to the other one. If I think, hey, I don't like that the second color I chose, then I can go over here to the site settings, global colors. I can change this color. So I grab this one. And I maintain the style, but I make it a bit darker. And then this will change. Everything will change because a lot of colors are linked to this global color. So in that way, you can change the look and feel of your style quite easily. The second word is go. So if I click over here, I go to the content, hover, I can make this text the same. Or I can say book, but I think it's unnecessary. So I just make it the same. And then I go to the style. And of the hover, I also need to make it. Let me see, label, hover, also uppercase. Like that. So what happens when we click over here? If we take a look at general, what happens? Nothing. But we can go to the advanced settings of the button, go to jet pop-up, and then we can select the pop-up. It's called book. So I select this one, click on the widget, and that's it. So now I refresh the page at 30wp.com. If I click over here, there it appears. The beard trim from Roy on this date with this time. Next, user email, phone, comment, and the total price, and you can pay. And we can get rid of this style, of course, just as I shown you. And if you want to edit this from this page, hover over here, and you see the book form pop up. And maybe it was better to add the page breaks later, because then we could see the styling of everything at once. Now we need to click, and sometimes that does not work, like right now. So that's a lesson I've learned. If I want to, I can get rid of those breaks and add them later. So I can go to the form. Go to Jet Engine Forms. Grab the form. And then at every page break, remove it. It's really easy to add them later. Update. Refresh this page. And now it's easier to change things over here. So if I go and select this area and I go to the style, I can close this and I can go to the appointment calendar. That sounded really Dutch. Okay, the header text color. How do you want to show the days? I can also make them red. Oh, those are the arrows. The names over here. Okay. I think the colors over here can be a little bit lighter. As you see, I think they can be white. So the available dates are highlighted, and when you hover over it, of course, it should become the primary color. And when it's active, it should also become active. So when I select this date, it should be stay red. But here it goes wrong again. Update. I need to press X, escape a few times, and then it worked. Click here over again. Yeah, I like that. So be careful. Click over here. Go to the style. And now it's selected. I still forgot one break. So let me see. Page break over here. Okay. Update. After updating, refresh. Are guys still having fun? I hope so. It's so much information. But I just want to show you how to build this. So you have a lot of freedom to do whatever you want to do. And then this is quite far away from each other. But it's okay. What I want to take a look at, what I want to do, I want to go to the submit button. And there it's hidden again. Solid, make it zero. Otherwise, it has some weird hidden border. Okay, then I want to go to the text, make it, sorry, it's not a box shadow, I don't want that. I want to go to the text typography, make it uppercase, make it a bit bigger. You're gonna book with an amazing barber. Okay, this is too big. Yes, as I said, a lot of space over there. It has to do with the range fields, maybe. Or the normal fields. You can increase the top. And the bottom. Okay, that has to do with the height of the area of the field. Let's say 15. Then there's the margin. That's the area above and below. So you can make it, bring it closer, but what happens is that the area below also becomes closer. So also here again, I'm not a CSS guru. I just need to play around. Maybe also over here. The gap. I think this is better. Zero. And then here. Also zero. So that's the gap. We're getting there. If I have capitals over here, I should also have them over here. And I think it is amazing. It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. When I was a single, I did my best to impress people. Girls, so I did this. That was a free addition to this tutorial. Okay, well, let's bring back the page breaks. One, two. One, two, three, four. First, after the selection, then after the provider, the barber, then after the date, yeah, that's enough, I think. First selection. And the barber and the date. So let's see. Remove the fourth one. Update. Let's go to the website. This is our website. Isn't that amazing? You've created such an amazing website. First one, the beard trim. Then the barber. Then the date and the time. Yes. Okay, again, I see something I should fix. And that's the time. Yeah. The time slot. Oh, but I brought this back again. Okay, let's see if we can get there. No. Oh, man. Okay, I will do this by heart. We need to go to the... Is it this one? Or should I go... Yeah, over here. The slots. Okay, perfect. The color should be white again. And when they're active, they become the primary one. And the border also becomes the primary one. That's it. So let's check it out. Book an appointment. Look at this, all white. And then when I select one, yeah, the only thing I should do is make the border also white. Well, you can figure that out for yourself. Next, user, phone, comment, book now. Perfect. How does it look on smartphone? Great. Because people can do that from a smartphone these days. Okay. Let's do a few things. Let's integrate this with WooCommerce so people can pay upfront if you want to. But first I want to bring this button up so you can see it on the homepage, on the hero. Edit with Elementor. Then I drag this up. Like that. Make this a little bit smaller. Okay, what I want to do now, go back to the desktop or to the dashboard. Click over here. Then I want to go to plugins, add new, add WooCommerce, install it now and activate it. I skip this area. No thanks. Okay. Then I go to appointments, settings. And then the first thing here, WooCommerce integrations. Yes, that's it. Of course, you can set it all up now, but let's see what happens. I go to the website. Oh, I like it. Nice. Oh, that's some nice trimmers. Okay, good prices. I like it. Okay, I want to book. Oh, wow, that looks great. We're going to make it look better. I want to have a haircut by Edward. And let's do Friday at 9 a.m. Next, my username is Ferdy. corpushook@gmail.com. My phone is this one. And I like to become bold. No, that's not true. I rebuke that. Total amount. Okay, $35. Okay, let's book now. But what happens? Look at this. Wow. I go to the checkout immediately. So I can leave my details over here. And I have to pay with pounds. But I can change it over here. At WooCommerce. Settings. I can leave all my details over here. And it will be great if there will be a tutorial about this. But guess what? There is. So what you can do, if you want to make this form easier, shorter, let people pay with PayPal, credit card, whatever, maybe a Dutch payment provider or something else, you can go to youtube.com. And you can search for Ferdy WooCommerce. And actually, WooCommerce tutorials should also be fine. WooCommerce tutorial. There it is. So here I talk about all this stuff. Oh, wow. Wow. This guy. He stole my MailChimp video one. Gewoon exactly. Like with the same highlighted words and stuff. So even by stealing, you can grow in your stuff. A lot of people are stealing. Funny. 7 months. Okay. Okay. No worries. So you can click over here.
Test payment.
And then here I talk about Stripe. So if you want to know about that, scroll down and see where I will talk about payment provider and Stripe. And then you can learn how to do that. So if you have, for instance, you have a big cowboy area in your town, that's your place with horses and cowboys, and you can have a party over there. Then you can say, yeah, I have an arrangement. People can sit on a horse, do laser gaming, and have a great dinner, all for the price of $600. Then it would be nice if they could pay upfront. So, and right now we're talking about barbershop things and paying a total amount of $35, but you can really sell things for hundreds of dollars. So this plugin is amazing. As I said before, when you buy this for $750, you also can create different kind of websites, and I will have tutorials about them. You can do so much things with this. And what I like is that there's a lifetime deal that can help you to have this for the rest of your life for unlimited websites. So if you have bought the cheapest package, you can also upgrade and then still make use of the great benefits of everything. So far so good. What I want to do now, I want to work with templates and listings. So we can make it look like this. So right now it looks like this. We click over here, we can select, but I want to click over here, make it look like this. And then I click on next, and I want to see an image of the instructor. So that's what we are going to do. And in order to do that, we go to the backend, remove this or close it. Then I go to Jet Engine and I go for listings. I add a new one. So what is a listing? A listing is a display of one item. So a service can be displayed in a listing. So if you have a listing of a service, I see one service, I can name the price, I can make a check mark, I can create the title of the service. With a listing, I can show everything below each other. So it will get all the services and show them in a listing. So I can style it a little bit better. So it is a post. The form post is services, and the name is barber. Service, like haircut. And I create it with Elementor. So that's it. Now we need to create display of the listing. So we need to fetch information from the custom post type and display it how we want it. So I click on the plus over here. I want to have three columns. And in the first one, I want to have a check mark. Check. Click on the plus. I can also search for a square, a filled square, or you know what, this is okay with me. Or this one, insert. And when it is checked, I search for check. This one. Okay. There you see it. Then I go to style. I can change the box size, let's say 24. Okay. Then I go to the second area. There I want to display the service. So I search for a dynamic field. And since it knows it's fetching information from service, it will probably already do that. So the mustache trim. And then I want to have another dynamic field. In the beginning, when I heard this for the first time, I was like, what is going on? But the more you play around with it, the more clear it becomes. So I need to get a source. metadata. And then I select the price per slot. So it will display that information. So before that, I want to have a custom field output. So if I say the dollar sign before, it will show $35. Okay, what I want to do, I click on the section area and I want to go to the height, change the minimum height. What happens if I say 50? Okay, let's increase it to 70. What I also can do, I can add a new area. And I can add an image over here, a dynamic image. And then it will probably get the image, the post thumbnail, like that. Okay, now everything else looks weird. So what I can do over here, can change the vertical of, or the vertical alignment to middle. Also over here, middle. Oh. If I cannot select this somehow, I can go to the navigator, go to the third column, and then select it that way. Middle, the fourth one, middle. This will be squished into the width of the pop-up. So it will not be separated like this. So we will see how it will look. This can be bigger, in my opinion. Not too big. This can also be bigger. So let's see what happens if I publish it. I can have a look. Well, okay, service. I don't see the image. I don't know why, but that's okay. I go back to the dashboard. Now I need to assign this listing to the form. Still understand how it works? I try to show you. Tell you as clear as I can to what's going on. So we have this listing, and if I go to the website, I want to book an appointment, I still see this. So I want to implement this listing over here. How can we do that? We need to go to the forms of Jet Engine, select our only form, and then over here, select the service. Select service, I make this a capital. And then what I can do, I can change the type from select to radio, and then fill options post, and then the post type services. And what I see when I scroll down, there's more information. So custom item template, yes, that's what we have. And then we can select it, service. Switch page on change. Yes. So when we select something, we go to the next step. So it will even be smoother. So when I apply it over here, again, don't forget to update it in that order. First apply, then update. Then refresh, book an appointment. It works. I think it looks funny. It's maybe not necessary to do this, but hey, why not? So what I can do now, I can change listing item service. I hold command. A few things. This looks great. This doesn't look great. So what I will do, I'll change the percentage in the width. So over here, I say 10%. Then over here, I say 40% or even 50. Then over here, I say 15. So let's see, 60, 75. Is it true? Is it 100 in total? 40. Yeah. Okay. Over here, I bring this to the center and I click here. bring it also to the center. Update, refresh this page. Okay. Well, it's okay, but I think it's not necessary, but it's nice. Don't you think that it was a possibility? I can make this 10, make this whatever I want. It doesn't matter. If I say 60, that means we have 30 left. But when I align this to the end or over here, click over here, go to style, bring it to the end or to the center, then it's all fine. So I think that looks better, but I just wanted to show you what is possible. Perfect. I want to go for the beard trim and then we can select the second one. So now I want to create the same thing over here. How can we do that? Well, we go back to Jet Engine, listings, and maybe I can duplicate it. Well, I can open it in a new tab and I can add a new one. Posts. This time, barbers, set listing name, barbers, and list it with Elementor. Guys, I don't know about you, ladies. I like this, man. The same principles are applied when creating a hotel booking website or an Airbnb website, booking.com. So when you know this, you can also create other websites. And if not, I can make tutorials about it and you can learn it. So I want to save some time. Copy this area, paste it. Then this time I want to add, duplicate this area. I want to use the image again, dynamic image. Drag it over here. Maybe make it a bit smaller if that is possible. The only way I can make it smaller probably is by making this area smaller. So I don't need this area. I need the name. Oh yeah, I need to change something. Okay, this becomes 10. Come on, work with me, 10. Yeah, this one becomes 50, then this one 40, but that's way too big. So maybe also 10. And then this one 80. Yeah. I can go over here. I can play around with the radius, make it rounder. Wait, just the, yeah, it's the border radius, maybe in percentage, and then 25. Am I at the right place? I don't think so. No, I should go to the image. Border radius, 25 or 50, I don't know. Okay. Publish, and then I think I need to change a thing. So I need to go back to the dashboard. Because this is not a name. So I go to the dashboard of the barbers and then here I change. Yeah, it is barbers. Okay. Okay. Well, let's see what happens. I go back to the form. By now you should know what the ID is. We go to the form. We change the provider. Oh, that looks complicated. I want to make use of a template. And it's barbers. Okay. Apply, update. Let's check it out. Okay. Mustache. And it is working. It only takes a second before they load. So I select Edward. Then I need to click on next. So I need to fix that. How can I do that? Really simple. I go to the appointment provider. And then over here, you almost do not see it. Switch page on change. Yes. Okay. Apply changes. Update. Okay. So let's see. Let's check if it's there. Yes. Okay. Well, our form is almost finished. Beard trim. Roy. On this date. This time. Next. Okay. User email, phone. And we can pay immediately. And you don't see this because I'm logged in. So if the visitor is not logged in, you don't see this. There are a few more things I want to change. This white area. So I can open the book form pop-up. First, I want to grab the background color of the section. So I go to this section style background, copy this code. Then I go over here to the settings style pop-up container background type color and I paste it so that area will also be white. So when I refresh this and I click over here, it's all the same color. And then the second thing, if I select something and I select a barber, I want to go back. I see no back button in order to get there. I go to the dashboard. Then I go to Jet Engine Forms. Then I go to all the page breaks. I click over here. I check this and I say back. Apply. The second one. Check it and say back. Apply in the third one. Check it and say back. Apply and then I need to update it. Then I can refresh this page again. And now if I think I want to have a beard trim, you know what? Rather shaving. I want to go back. But this back thing looks ugly. So I close this and I want to open this. Let me see. In a new tab again. Let's style this because this looks really, really bad. So I select the beard trim. Okay. The back button. I click over here. I go to the style and then I go to the previous page button. Is it that one? It seems so. Yes. Okay. We're at the right place. I think this is okay. There can be a little bit more padding. Let's say 15 on left and right. I don't want it to get too much attention. About 0. So what I can do, I can make it almost as dark as the other background and then a little bit lighter. Okay. And then the back text can be darker. Okay. It can be a little bit lighter, but I don't want it to be too distracting. Okay. And maybe I want it to be at the, at the left is okay. You know what? Make it 20. Make it 5. Okay. And if you want to, you can play around with it so it will align better. So let's go one more time to the back end. Maybe it has something to do over there with the forms. We need to do one more thing. I cancel this and close this. Over here, post submit actions. I need to click over here and we have the phone field and we need to connect that. And the comments field and the total. So that's great. Update and now it's all set up. So we are almost there. What I want to do, I want to make sure that when people book an appointment, I get an email or the owner of the barbershop. So how can we do that? Well, first I want to go to the Jet Engine, no, Jet appointment settings. And I want to turn off WooCommerce again because people can pay at the local barber instead of paying upfront. Okay, then I go to Jet Engine forms. I go to our form. Then I want to scroll down to the, let me see, to the post submit actions. What should happen when somebody submits an action? Well, here in our system, we will see the details here at appointments, but I want to add a new notification. I want to get an email. And it seems that Alexa heard that. So it's saying send an email instead of another option. So I click over here. Here I can change the option. I want to send an email. Mail to the admin email or an email I choose. So maybe I'm the admin, but someone else owns the barbershop. Well, in that case, I can say custom email. And that email in this case is info@verdicorpushook.com. When people reply or when I want to reply on the email I get, I want to reply to the email that is submitted in the form. Reply to email from the user email. And the subject is thank you for your booking. Or this will enter, this will go into the mailbox of the receiver. There is a new booking or, and then I can even grab a code. So let me see. Provider. Let's see if that works. So there's a new booking for Edward, Roy, or Thomas from, well, the Super Barbershop. Barbershop. New York. From email address. Well, the best thing is to have your own email address. Otherwise, you can go to the spam or you say, from user email, but I say info@verdicorpushook. The type is in HTML, and what should that email be? Hey Ferdy, that's me. There is a new booking. What do I need to know? When? The appointment date. When? By who? Who's going to do the cutting, the haircut or the mustache? Which service? Phone. Client. Maybe first a name. Is there no name? I should definitely add a name, of course. Make it so much more personal. Comments. Total amount. And then I add those two. And I apply the changes and then I click on update. So let's see. I book an appointment. I want to have a haircut. That's the only thing I can get. I want it to be done by Roy because of, for all time's sakes, he was my best friend when I was young. And let's do it early in the morning. My username, verdicorpushook@gmail.com. Phone. I can, by the way, also send an order confirmation email to that client. I should definitely do that. Oh, my own number. I want to look like Cristiano Ronaldo. Book now. Okay. I should redirect them to a thank you page. Right now, that's, I only see success, but I get an email. That's a good thing. Verticorpshoek, there's a new booking for, okay, provider doesn't work, but I can say from the barbershop. Hey, Ferdy, there's a new booking. When? January the 29th at 9 a.m. By who? Which service? That's not, that's not fun. That's not really not fun. Phone number, client. I want to look like Cristiano Ronaldo with the amount. Okay, here. Okay, this is what I don't need. I need this. I don't need this stuff. So, guys, I'm still learning. But if I go to my Gmail account, there's no confirmation. So what I will do, I'll go back to the forms. This one. Click over here. And then service title. Got it. Paste it. Got it. Paste it. So that's better. Apply changes. And then I click on, you know what? I will copy this stuff. Then I add a new email. Send email to email from the submitted form field from user email. Reply to custom email. Reply to info at Verticorpshoek. So if that person wants to reply, it goes to me. Subject of his email, your booking is confirmed, configured, confirmed with a capital C from Verticorpshoek, from info at Verticorpshoek. And I want to add a lot of stuff. I definitely should have a name in the form. Hey there. We are looking forward. Okay. We just want to confirm that we received your booking. We are looking forward to see you at soon. When? You will be served by this guy? No. No. You'll be served by this guy. Your treatment is this one. Your comments that can be paid at the store. Cheers. 30. Apply the changes. So, an email to myself and an email to the one who is a new customer. I go to new page, hold command or control on the PC. I start typing. Thank you for your order. You will receive a confirmation soon. Command A. Okay. Publish. Go back to all the pages. No title. Quick edit. Say thank you so much. Copy. paste, update. Okay, then I go back to the Jet Engine forms. And then I add a new action. This time, not an email, but a redirection to a page, which is a current page. Page ID. Or a static page. And then it's thank you so much. Okay. Apply. So what do we have? After booking the appointment, I get appointment information over here through this. I get an email as the website owner, like, hey, I get a new client for a barber. I see all the information for who is it. I want to change one more thing over there. There's a new booking from the barber shop, or new booking. Apply the changes. The person who did the booking gets an email notification and will be redirected to that page where it will say that you get an email update. So now I open this incognito, like I've never been here before. I'm like, wow, I need to go here. I want to book an appointment. Okay. I want to go for a haircut done by Roy. I can be there the Saturday. Okay, no available slots. How about Friday? 9:30. Because 9 a.m. is already taken. Okay, my username or email address, corp@gmail.com. My phone number. I have no comments. I say, book now. So what will happen? I will be redirected to this page, which I cannot see. Really weird. And I get an email. So far, so good. New booking. There's new booking. January 29th, 9:30 by who? I should change those to by haircut with service Roy. Okay. The phone number, the client and the comment. Okay. I need to take a look at this. Okay. Then I go to my Gmail account. Your booking is confirmed. Hi there. Just want to confirm that we receive a booking. We're looking forward to see you soon. When? Okay. Okay. I'm going to do one more thing just because I want to make this complete. I go to Jet Engine. No, appointments, settings. Then I go to tools, column name is name, save it. Okay. Then I want to go to the form, Jet Engine forms, static page booking form. We go to user email. Above that area, I go over here, click here, make a text. The text is a text. Field name, yes. And the label is your name. It is required. Apply changes. Then I go to the appointment. I select the name field, field name, apply. Then I go to myself, send email. This email goes to me. Field name is added now. From this guy. Again, I need to switch those. Apply the changes, and now I need to go to the. No, I think it's added to the form now. Did I miss something? Well, yes. Send an email to the client from blah blah blah. Then I can say, hey, field name. So it make it personal. Hey, Ferdy, total amount that can be paid. Then see you soon and add the name again. Make it personal, automatic personal. Update. Okay, one more time. Wait, incognito. Okay. Haircut by Roy. 29th. 9:30 is taken, as you see. Next. My name. Wow, that's personal. Let's call myself Cristiano Bieber Gomez. ferdycorp@gmail.com. Book now. Okay, the thank you page, that looks crappy. New booking. Hey, Ferdy, from Cristiano Bieber Gomez. By who? Roy. Which service? Haircut. Okay. Sounds good. Let's go to my Gmail. And then my Gmail account. Hey, Cristiano Bieber Gomez. See you soon, Cristiano Bieber Gomez. So this is amazing. This, if you can make this for a client, you can make a lot of money. You buy this package, the whole package. You throw it into your services that you offer. I can make appointment websites for you for karting or for parties or whatever. You can do it. And you are the man. You get more clients. You make more money. And in that way, everybody's happy. Congratulations. If you're here, that means that you watched the whole tutorial or just the latest part. Or maybe you applied already everything. And you have a beautiful website with a booking system. Well, whatever the case is, thank you for being here. And good luck with the business you have. As I said before, already multiple times, you can sell this as a service. And if you have the CrocoBlock subscription, you can make websites for clients. It's totally legal. So it's a great way to make extra money and at the same time, help other people. I hope you like this video. If that is the case, please like it. And feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress-related tutorials. Have a great day and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.